All right, welcome everybody. Welcome to New Beginnings Church of the Big Ben. So happy Sunday morning to you. Feliz domingo por la mañana. And you prepare yourself to receive what God has for you. Amen. Prepárese a recibir lo que el Señor tenga para usted. Before we do this, grab your Bibles. And church, let's say it like we mean it. Amen. Amen. This is my Bible. I am what it says I am. I have what it says I have. I can do what it says I can do. Today, I'll be taught the word of God. I boldly confess my mind is alert, my spirit is receptive, and I'll never be the same in Jesus' name. Amen. The Bible says the battlefield is the mind. So before you come, before you meet with him, just get your mind in order. Amen. I know what you're thinking. I said, what time the Cowboys play? Are they going to win today? They're on a losing streak, you know. So, hey, we'll just pray for them, okay?
Yeah.
We'll just pray for them. But anyway, prepare yourselves to receive what God has for you. And if you're not prepared to receive, you need to get that attitude right. Amen.
Amen.
You got to have winning attitude. And you know what? He's got something for me.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, but if you don't want to hear from God, I do.
Yes,
amen. Yeah. We need to hear from him on a daily basis. Amen. He's looking for available people, not perfect people.
Yeah.
Amen. So
yeah.
Make yourself available. He wants to. He's knocking, and we need to open up, you know.
Amen.
If he was to call you right now, would you answer? Yes.
Mm.
Hallelujah. So, you know, he wants to bless you. He wants to encourage you. He wants to change you, and he wants to correct us. Amen.
Yes.
It's, you know, we want to get on the right track. We want to get on track with him. Amen. And continue to do what he wants us to do. And there's so many distractions in this negative world. And if we don't correct and get on the right track, you know, we can end up in a ditch somewhere, you know.
Yes.
So the enemy comes to steal, kill, and destroy. You got to remember that. When you remember that, you say, you know, it's time to get back with God. Amen.
Yes.
But you know, the main thing to do is stay hungry for him.
Yeah.
Stay thirsty for the water.
That's right.
The living water. Amen. The water is God. Amen. The Holy Spirit wants to come and show us and teach us, amen, more and more about God. Whew, I got so much, and just get yourselves ready. We're going to be talking about closing the old year and starting the new year, amen. So we got a few more weeks of Sundays to talk about this, but you know, we're coming to an end, and sometimes if you think about and you allow yourself, the enemy's going to pull you and say, you know what, you had a failing year.
Yeah.
You didn't accomplish what you wanted to accomplish, you know, and you start thinking about all the bad things, and you start thinking about the past, and you put yourself there, but you know, you have a choice.
Mm-hmm.
You have a choice to say, you know what, I'm not going to go there. I'm just going to press on with God, and I said this, closing the old with a bang and opening the new with a bang. Amen.
Yeah.
Or you could say with a winning attitude, with pressing on, with excitement, with commitment, with serving and being available. Amen. That's how you want to do it. You want to close it this way, but you also want to open it this way. Lord, I'm here. I'm available. Amen. Whoo, hallelujah. Amen. If you open your Bibles, this is going to be our text. Open your Bibles to the book of Philippians. That's in the New Testament. Thank you. And you know, while we're still fresh, I wanted to correct myself and let you know that I think I said last week that Paul wrote 2/3 of the Bible, and that's not right. He wrote 2/3 of the New Testament.
Right.
Okay. So you know, if you hear me say something, let me know. I can be corrected. I'm not perfect. But anyway, Philippians chapter 3 and verses 12 through 14. Amen? Mm-hmm.
12 through 14, I'm going to read it out of the New Testament, so you read it out of your translation there.
Amen.
It says, not that I have already attained, or I'm already perfect, but I press on. We're going to hear this word, you know, as we're closing this year. We want to press on. Amen.
Yeah.
Ain't nothing to slow down about. We're going to press on. And guess what? When we start the new year, we want to press on with him. Amen. So press on that I may lay hold of that for which Christ Jesus has laid a hold of me.
Yeah.
says 13 says, brethren, I do not count myself to have apprehended, but one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind or the past and reaching forward to those things which are ahead. And verse 14 says, I press towards the goal for the prize of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus. Amen.
So be thinking about that. Amen. That is good. You cannot start a new chapter in your life if you keep rereading the old one. You know, you're reading a book, exciting book, you know. You can't wait to turn the page to the next one, you know, and it's going to be so good, you know, and you just keep turning pages, and it's so exciting. You ended it excited, and you open it excited, and that's every day, opening every day as you walk, one day at a time with Him. You close it excited, and you open a new one excited. Now, who has a choice? You have a choice. Amen. Don't let the world, don't let people, don't let anybody distract you and make it a bad day for you. Amen. This is the day the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Okay, so that's your choice. So don't let nobody come and just suck up all the excitement out of you. Because there's a lot of people out there. There's a lot of vision busters. There's a lot of dream busters. There's a lot of people out there that just going to want to tell you how it is, you know, and they're going to come and want to tell you and give you a piece of their mind. You got to know when to say, hey, I don't receive that. Amen. We know how to hit delete and say, I'm not receiving that. Let it go. Never close out or start a new day or a new year in idle or in neutral. I say, I'm just going to be, you know, the Bible talks about lukewarmness or just straddling the fence, you know. It says either be hot or cold, but don't be lukewarm. Amen. So don't, you don't start an idol and say, hey, I'm just going to take the safe place, you know. I'm just going to be neutral. No. You know, God don't want you that way. Close and start by praising Him. Close and start by rejoicing Him.
Yes.
Close and start with a winning attitude.
Amen.
Start and close by having the right priority. And the right priority is to seek Him first.
Amen.
Amen. You know, we all work and we all have priorities. But we got to put Him on top of our priority list. Amen.
Yes.
He wants to be first.
Yes,
amen.
Yes.
He's the jealous God. He says. So don't put Him on the bottom of your list.
That's right.
And you say, hey, you know, before I go to bed, I'll just spend time with Him. No, why don't you spend time with Him first? Because the world is going to be waiting for you. And they're going to have your lunch. If you ain't right, if you ain't ready, and you haven't spent time with Him, they're going to have you. Amen. So remember that. Letting go of the past. Listen, failures, mistakes, problems, worries, lacks, mindsets, traditions, bad habits, bad companies, bad attitudes. Amen. Some of these things, distractions, they try to just come and take you away.
Oh, yeah.
Amen. So be careful. Let go of the past. We're going to be talking some more in a few minutes. But close the old year and open up the new year with a bang, with excitement. This is your choice.
Yeah.
Amen. I'm not concerned about who's there on my side or behind me. You know, I am serving Him. My priority is to serve Him. Amen.
Yeah.
Listen to this. You can write this down. If you know it, that's fine. But if you don't have it, write it down. Never be a prisoner of your past.
Right.
It was there for a lesson and not a life sentence.
That's right.
Amen. But you got the enemy, the devil, and he uses people, sometimes family, sometimes friends, sometimes co-workers, to remind you of all your past. Let it go. Just let them know, I don't live there anymore. I'm a new child of God. I have a new life. So I don't live there anymore. Even though they bring it to you and they tell you all these things, that's not me anymore. Amen. You had a spiritual birth. You're a new birth. You had a new birth. Amen.
Yes.
Start and end every day and every year by staying positive and have a winning attitude and not a negative attitude in this negative world.
Yeah.
Or whatever circumstances you face. Amen. Because those things are going to come. Trouble's going to come. But He says, cast it on me. because I care for you. Yes. Amen. You're on a mission for me. I'm going to take care of you. Psalms 23 and 4. Let's go there. Well, let's read the whole thing. Yeah. It's not that long. But concentrating on verse 4. Psalms 23. And we all have different translations, so you read it out of your translation. It's okay. The New Bible and the pages are really sticking. Says, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me.
Yeah.
You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Yeah.
Amen. Forever. But yeah. Verse 4 says, yea, though I walk through the valley of shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me.
Yes.
So he says he never leaves you nor forsakes you. He's always with you.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. And you know, he's God on the mountain. He's God in the valley. Amen. He's with you all the time. Just remember that. So, you know, he's God with you yesterday. He's God with you today. He's God with you this year. And he'll be God with you next year. We just got to keep pressing on and serving him. Amen.
Amen.
So praise God. Amen. Woo! On your daily walk, on the mountaintops, on the valleys, he's still God. Amen.
Yes, he is.
Hallelujah. He says, I'm God. I change not.
Mm-hmm.
And he's always with you. Remember that. People will tell you different.
Yeah,
but they're not serving him.
Mm-mm.
Daily. They're not serving him. They not haven't made a commitment to serving him. Things must be released. In Colossians 3, 1 through 4, I'm going to read it to you from the NIV. It says, since then you have been raised with Christ, set your hearts on things above, which Christ is,
mm-hmm.
seated at the right hand of God.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 2 says, set your minds on things above,
mm-hmm.
and not on earthly things. And 3 says, for you died, and your life is now hidden with Christ in God.
Mm-hmm.
And verse 4 is, when Christ, who is your life, appears, then you also will appear with him in glory. Amen.
Yeah.
So we must clean our spiritual lives. We fight a spiritual battle on a daily basis. Where is the battlefield? In the mind. Amen.
Yeah.
And we fight the spiritual battle on a daily basis. We are to renew our minds. If we don't renew our minds, we can just fall back. We're to feed our spirit, man. We're tribune. We have a spirit, we have a soul, and we live in this physical body.
Mm-hmm.
And the Bible says, feed your spirit the word of God.
Yes.
Renew your mind with the word of God and crucify the flesh.
Uh-huh.
Amen. And the flesh doesn't want to do anything. The flesh don't want you to come to church. The flesh don't want you to hear the word. The flesh don't want you to read the word. Amen. But the stronger you feed your spirit and renew your mind, the flesh has to sit and go along. Amen. So praise God.
Yeah.
So we must clean our spiritual lives. Even though we fight the spiritual battle on a daily basis, we cast it on him. 1 Peter 5:7 says, he's not giving us a spirit of fear, but a power, love, and a sound mind. But in 1 Peter 5:7, he says to what? Cast it all on him. Cast all these things on him because he cares for us. Amen. So these things are going to come up, and they're going to come up in your mind, and that's what the enemy uses.
Mm-hmm.
And he uses people to remind you of these things. But you're going to have to cast it on him.
Mm-hmm.
And even though people bring it up, I am not receiving it. Amen. I'm not receiving that. And we got to cast it on him. Release it, let it go, let God, and renew your mind. Amen. So things try to attach themselves to you on a daily basis. Things, you know, as you prepare yourself to go out and you walk or wherever you go, your physical body gets dirty.
Your clothes get dirty.
Oh, yeah.
You know, you go work. So these things attach themselves to you. Spiritually, things attach themselves to you. They want to attach themselves to you. So you, what you do is, at the end of the day, you wash yourself, you bathe yourself, and you get these, you clean your body. You clean your clothes. Spiritually, you got to give yourself a spiritual bath, because these things don't want to attach themselves to you. And if you don't detach these things from you, they're going to dictate which way you can go. Amen. And don't let these things dictate where you're going. All you need to do is renew your mind and say, I'm not receiving this. I'm going to press on with the things of God.
Amen.
And you know, also the main thing is you need to know the Word of God, because the Word of God is the truth. And when people come and tell you this or that, and so said, well, it's not scriptural. And if it's not scriptural, I'm going to stay with what the Word of God says.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. I'm glad you told me that, but I'm going to put it on the shelf.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not receiving that. I'm going to press on with what the Word of God says, because I know what the Word of God says. So I'm not going to compromise and try to please people. I'm going to be a God pleaser, not a man pleaser. Amen?
Yeah.
So these things don't have to have a place in my life, because our Romans 12, 1 and 2 says that I must renew my mind.
Mm-hmm.
Amen? Let's go there. Romans 12, 1 and 2. Romans chapter 12, verses 1 and 2. I know you know these things, but you know, hey, we're learning the Word too. And it's good. Amen? All right. Romans chapter 12, 1 and 2. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable to God, which is your reasonable service. And do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed, how? By renewing your minds,
yes.
That you may be proved, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Amen.
Yes.
So we need to renew our minds. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
And people are going to hold things against you. People are going to bring things up to you. And the enemy is going to see to it. You know, the closer you come to God, the more he's going to attack.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. If you're not being attacked, maybe you need to get saved. Because the enemy is going to be busy. Maybe he's already got you.
Yeah.
It's time, you know, all you need to do is say, Lord, I repent. I've sinned against you. Come into my life. Be my Lord and Savior. Amen. And start your life with Christ. Amen. That's all you need to do. Praise God. It's time we accept him and serve him. Whatever the Lord takes, whatever you cast on him, whatever the Lord takes, let it go.
Yes.
Don't take it back.
Amen.
Amen. Let me see. I wrote something here. As we walk daily or work, clothes and body gets dirty. It says things attach themselves to you physically and spiritually. So we give ourselves a bath. Physically and spiritually, to get those things off of us. Amen. Because they're going to attach themselves. They want to attach themselves. Your clothes get dirty. Your body gets dirty. So your spirit gets dirty. These things want to attach themselves to you. And you have to give yourself a spiritual bath and get these things away from you. Amen. These are not for me. And I don't want them on me. Amen. Paul tells us in Colossians 3 and 2 says, focus on thoughts of heavenly things. Avoid getting caught up in the worldly things.
Yeah.
Things that pollute your mind. So the battlefield is the mind. Amen.
Yeah.
Things, distractions, and people that hinder our walk. Enemy wants to hinder your walk on a daily basis. Remember, he comes to steal, kill, destroy.
Yeah.
And he doesn't want you to be a servant of God. He doesn't want you serving God.
That's right.
He doesn't want you to do anything good for God. He wants to stop you. And you know, if we're not feeding our spirit the word, and we're not renewing our minds, the flesh is going to be entertained real quick and real fast, because you're not hungering for the things of God. You're hungering for things of the flesh, for the things of the world. And the world is going to entertain you real fast. And sometimes we come to church with that mentality, you know, that, well, you know, I'm going to find me a new church because they don't entertain me that well.
Mm-hmm. You didn't come to be entertained. You came to encourage, assemble ourselves together and encourage one another. Mm-hmm. And to hear the word of God and hear the message and hear what God has to say.
Yes.
Amen. For us to be strong, renewed, so we can go out and do what God has called us to do and be a blessing to somebody. Amen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. So I think I saw a picture yesterday on Facebook where these people are sitting in a football game and they're snowed in.
Yeah.
You say, well, how many of you won't go to church? Because conditions ain't right in church, you know. It's too hot. You got two comfy seats in here. Well, I don't like the person next to me, but I can go to a football game and sit amongst hundreds of thousands of people. And they all have the same good attitude. They screaming at you, hollering at you. And I see you jumping up and down. You come to church and you sit real nice and don't say a word. The bad thing is you're not allowing the word to go in and minister to you. Amen. That's what we need to do. Allow the word to come in and clean us up and encourage us.
Amen.
And that's what he wants to do. Encourage you, bless you. Amen. And correct us. Focus the mind on things of God. Amen. Renewing your mind. Hallelujah. Amen. Paul mentioned some dangerous distractions that can hinder our walk.
No,
amen. False doctrines. You know, I see this all the time. I don't know about you, but I see people walking away from God and following someone else or following tradition or following false religions. If you don't know what the Word of God says, somebody's going to tell you something and they're going to tickle you right and you're going to follow them. Mm-hmm. Amen. Remember Jim Jones?
No.
And there's been many, many, many Jim Jones. Mm. People got sold out. Because they didn't know what the Word of God says.
Mm.
Amen. And you got to know. They make it sound so good.
Mm.
But if it's not in the Word of God, it's not scriptural.
Mm-hmm.
You know, hey, I'm not going that way. I'm not buying that. I'm going to go with what the Word of God says. So many people are walking away from the body of Christ because somebody tickled the ear a different way. Hey, and this is a new thing. Everything from A to Z in the Bible is the Word of God.
Mm.
Everything is... it's new, okay? It's nothing. This has just been discovered. No.
Yeah.
It's been, everything in the Bible covers what we need to know.
Mm-hmm.
Say amen. So praise God.
Woo.
Either say amen or say oh me. False doctrines. The enemy would love for God's people to get themselves trapped in some false doctrine, false teachings that takes the emphasis of Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing can take the place of God. Who went to the cross? Who died for your sins?
Yeah.
Yeah. God gave his only begotten son. Jesus came and died for your sins.
Amen.
No one else did.
That's right.
So know the truth. The truth is going to set you free. Amen.
Amen.
The tradition of men. When we're not to base our faith on and walk on the traditions of men,
that's right.
No matter how godly or worthy of respect a man may be, we are to base our belief systems on the Word of God. Amen?
Yes.
I was brought up a certain way, and I thought this way. But when I started reading the Word myself, I went with what the Word of God says, and I followed Christ, and I'm serving Christ now, and not the tradition of men. And sometimes this is the way the family brought me, but I know the Word now, so I'm following the Word of God. Amen? Not what the family or what so-and-so told me. But I'm following what the Word of God is, says. Amen. So we need to do the same thing.
Yes.
And if you got somebody that's lost in a cult or whatever, you know, just pray for them. God's going to use the right people to get them out. Amen. Just pray for them. Don't get discouraged and don't get upset. That ain't going to help you none. The best thing to do is just pray for them.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. God can reach them when we can't. So we're closing out to 219 and entering into the 2020, I guess we'll all have perfect vision then. With a bang, with excitement, with new opportunities, with new assignments, with new beginnings, with new spiritual growth. Amen.
Yeah.
We must grow on a daily basis in the things of God.
Yeah.
Don't see yourself a loser, see yourself a winner.
Yeah.
Amen. We're so quick to see the bad instead of the good.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. So see the good and not the bad.
Amen.
But we are growing on a daily basis. From day to day, we're growing. Amen.
Yes.
If it's one word, one scripture, we're growing in things of God. Start fresh on things that we want to accomplish. Personally, a better health, maybe a better business, better work goals. Amen. Spiritually, we want to continue to grow spiritually. Amen. Don't let Satan, don't let people, again, don't let people, don't let things, distractions, excuses, or you hold you back.
Yeah.
Because sometimes we feel like we're not qualified. When you start feeling that way, it's time to press on with Him. Amen. When you start feeling like, well, God can't use me, you know, and you start feeling like you ain't got what it takes, but you did. You know why you're here? Because God put you here. And God has called you and qualified you, and He wants you to fulfill. Amen. Don't let Satan, people, things, or excuses hold you back. Be excited to close out the old, but be excited also to open the new. Amen. Excited. Well, just pressing on with the things of God. Amen. We're pressing on with Him. Hallelujah. Pressing on towards the goal for the prize. And what is the prize? Heaven is our home. Hey, you know, this is not my home. We just passed it through. Heaven is our home. Amen. But you don't know that until you know what the Word of God says. Amen. Isaiah 43 and 18 and 19 says this in the New Living Translation. It says, do not remember the things that happened before. Do not think about the things of the past. 19 says, see, I will do a new thing. I will begin happening now. A new day, a new year, a new beginning. Will you not know about it? I will even make a road in the wilderness and a river in the desert.
Yeah.
Amen. Or I will open the Red Sea for you so you can cross. Amen. As you spend time with Him, you know, you don't know what was waiting for you. You don't know what giants are waiting for you.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, as you spend time with Him, He cleared all that for you.
Yeah.
Amen. And even if it's still there, you know He is with you. Nothing can hold me back except me. Amen.
Yeah.
I can stop me. So you got to deal with that. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me.
Amen.
2 Corinthians 5:17 says, therefore, if anyone's in Christ, he is a new creation.
Yes.
Again, people are going to hold you back and say, I know who you are. You're nobody. You're no good. The world will tell you, you're not qualified. You don't have what it takes. God says, I've approved you. I have chosen you.
Mm-hmm.
I have equipped you. I have anointed you. What are you waiting for? It's time to get up and press on with Him. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. All things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. They don't see. You had a spiritual birth, but they don't see the spiritual side. They see the physical side. So they see the same person inside. I'm a new creature in Christ.
Yes. Amen.
So I need to start reading the Word, getting the Word in me. Amen. And now pressing on and being more Christ-like and doing the things of God. Amen. People will see your actions and they'll see your words have changed and your company has changed.
Yes.
Wow, you've changed. See, you can't hang out with us no more. That's all right. I don't want to. Oh, God has given me a new place, a new thing to do. Amen. Colossians 3, 4, and Colossians, we just read this, but Colossians 3, verses 3 and 4, chapter 3, verses 3 and 4, in the Message translation says, your old life is dead. Your new life, which is your real life, even though invisible to spectators, that's what we're talking about, you can't see your spiritual life. Amen. It's Christ in God. He is your life. When Christ, your real life, remember, shows up again on this earth, you will show up too. The real you, the glorious you. Meanwhile, be content with obscurity like Christ. Amen.
Yeah.
So you're a new creature in Christ. So don't let yourself and don't let the world hold you back. Amen. We're pressing on. That's all right. We're closing out the old.
Mm-hmm.
And don't let the enemy take you back and say, you know what? I thought you was going to do this. I thought you was supposed to accomplish this. And you start feeling bad because, well, I didn't do this and I didn't do that, you know. And, wow, you know, start feeling bad for yourself. No, I say, you know what? New Year's coming. And with Christ, I could do all things. Amen. I'm a new creature in Christ. And I'm going to press on with him. And all these things are going to come to pass. Amen. Woo. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Lamentations 3:23-22 says this. The steadfast love of Christ never ceases. His mercies are new. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. Amen. So the mercies of God are new on a daily basis. Amen. They change. Thank you, Lord, for your mercy.
Amen.
Thank you for your grace. Hallelujah. We've already read this one, but Psalms 118:24 says, this is the day the Lord has made. Rejoice and be glad in it. Receive it. Amen. Hallelujah. We got an awesome sign in the back. Let me put my glasses on. It says, each day is a gift. Receive it with an attitude of gratitude. Thank you, Lord, for this beautiful day that you have given me to serve you. Amen. And I can do all things through Christ. Greater is he that's in me than he that's in the world. No matter what comes against me, greater is he that's in me than he that's in the world. And things are going to come your way.
Yeah.
But you cast on him all these other things that try to come against you. Amen.
Amen.
I'm not receiving this. Amen. Learn from the Apostle Paul. We all have an imperfect past. Sometimes we feel shame of it. Sometimes wish we hadn't done or no one knew about it. We must forget them quickly and press on, because you're just going to sit down and stop. And this game of life is just going to pass you by. People are going to hold it against you. The enemy is going to see to it. We must know that every bad thing about us, God knows every bad thing about us, and guess what? He loves you the most.
Yes, he does.
Amen. So who are we to hold against anybody else? They've got to see the Christ in us.
Yes.
They've got to see the love and compassion of God come from us.
Amen.
Amen. And that's what people are going to open up. It's not what you know, it's who you know.
Mm-hmm.
And when they see that, they're going to open up.
Yeah.
And let them speak into them. Amen. Hallelujah. They're going to see the Christ just flow through you. Amen. The Apostle Paul was no different. Imperfect past. God's looking for available people, not perfect people. Listen, I was in between here, but it says imperfect past. I'm going to read to you a list that you've already seen before and heard before, but we're going to talk about our Bible heroes. Amen. Our Bible heroes in a few minutes. So he's looking for available people, not perfect people. So get rid of the mindsets. Get rid of the traditions.
Yeah.
Amen. And that's what people, all they want to believe is what they can see.
Mm-hmm.
But faith is believing those things that you cannot see.
Right.
Have faith as you step out on a daily basis. Amen. Peter says, that's Jesus. Jesus, I want to come where you are. He says, come. He's walking on water. Jesus says, come. That's all he says, come. And he started walking on the water. Amen. So, you know, just get rid of the old mindsets and the traditions. Don't be a prisoner or a slave of your past. Paul could have said, I've done no worse. I've persecuted Christians. I've executed Christians. There's no hope for me. Sounds familiar? And so many people love you so much, but say, you know, there's no hope for you. You're a big mistake.
Mm.
There's no way I could ever be used by God. Sounds familiar? Mm. God is not looking for perfect people. He's looking for available people. Amen?
Yeah.
I should have read these to you a few minutes ago, but I've got some things here I want to read to you. Amen? And you've seen these before, but let me read this to you. If you think God cannot use you because of your past, remember these Bible heroes, okay? So we think about our Bible heroes. Well, guess what? We're completing the mission God has put us in. So somebody's going to see you and say, hey, he was one of my heroes. because they brought me and I accepted Christ. Amen. They ministered to me. So here's your, some of your Bible heroes of your past, of the past here. Noah was a drunk. God used him. None of these heroes were perfect. Abraham was too old. You know, sometimes we feel like, I'm too old. God can't use me. What could I do? You start comparing yourself to the world and not listening to what the Word of God is saying. Amen. Isaac was a daydreamer. Jacob was a liar. Leah was ugly. I'm too ugly. God can't use me. You know? Joseph was abused. You know, he could have spent his whole time in prison because his family gave him away, sold him away into slavery. But that's not stopped him, you know. It's a hunger and a thirst that you have, that drive in, that you want to press on with the things of God.
Amen.
And not let people dictate to you.
Right.
Amen. Moses was stuttering problem. He told God, you can't use me. I said, I can't speak well.
Mm.
And God sent somebody to help him, his brother.
Yeah.
So Gideon was afraid. Samson was with long hair. You know, God, we don't allow nobody with long hair in this church. Jeremiah and Timothy were too young. The little boy with the lunch was only a kid. So you don't tell your children, you know, God can't use you. And don't tell yourself, God can't use me. Amen. I mean, this list just goes on and on and on and on, you know, but God used all these people. Peter denied Christ 3 times. And Jesus still used him in a mighty way. He could have said, you know what? I gave you a chance. You failed. So, you know, I'm done with you. He didn't say that.
No.
He says he was ready to die for Christ. He was ready to fight for Christ. And Jesus says, you know, before the night's over, before the cock crows, you'll deny me 3 times. And he did. And you know what? Jesus didn't say anything else. When the cock crowed the 3rd time, Jesus looked that way and saw Peter eye to eye. He said, I told you. He didn't say anything. He just looked at him. But Peter cried. But Jesus wasn't finished with him.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Jesus used him mightily to bring people to Christ. Amen. Ooh, hallelujah. Amen. So guess what? There's hope for me.
Yeah.
I'm not comparing. I'm not competing. I'm just making myself available.
Yeah.
Amen. We're to complete one another, encourage one another, and not compete. Amen. Hallelujah. Whatever your excuse is, God used all these people,
yeah,
all these Bible heroes. So whatever your excuse is, just throw it out the window.
Uh-huh.
Amen. and I'll close it with this.
Yeah.
He used a donkey.
Yeah.
So, hey, he can use me. You know what? My folks always calling me a burro. Man, you're a burro. You're a donkey. Well, God can still use me. Amen. There's hope for me. Not only that, he used Lazarus, and Lazarus was dead.
Oh, yeah.
Amen. So, hey, no matter what you've been through, you call yourself being dead, God can bring you out and use you. Amen. So, praise God. Just let all the past go and start serving it now, you know. We're closing out the old year.
Uh-huh.
And instead of thinking these things of all the things you failed, be excited. Say, Lord, I want more of you. So in the new year, I can complete all the things I didn't do this time.
Yeah.
You know? And I've got all of next year to complete what I didn't do this year.
Yeah.
And I'm going to press on and do more things for you. And be excited in serving him, you know,
yeah,
instead of being sad, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Just get yourself, get more of him in you and less of the world.
Yeah.
And you're going to be excited in serving him. Amen.
Yes.
I wrote this. This is my scriptural break, and I'll read it to you. But it says, I am with you, closing out the old year with a bang and opening the new year with a bang. I am with you. I will not leave you nor forsake you. You have when you decide on a course of action, this is the line, this is in line with my will. Nothing in heaven or in earth can stop you. You may encounter some obstacles as you press on towards your goal. But don't be discouraged. Never give up. Never quit. With my help, you can overcome any obstacle. It won't be an easy path as you journey hand in hand with me. But do remember, I am your very present help. I am omnipotent, almighty, all-powerful, invincible, unstoppable. If you want to stay close to me and do things my way, ask me and show you the path for your new day, for your new year, for your new life, for life. Instead of dashing on ahead towards your goal, let me set the pace. Slow down. Enjoy the journey in my presence.
Yes.
It's awesome, you know.
Yeah.
If you want a copy, I'll give you a copy. But anyway, we're to press on with him, hand in hand with him, amen?
Yeah.
And not be afraid of what the future brings, because I know he's already been there.
Yeah.
And I receive that in Jesus' name, amen?
Yeah.
So hallelujah.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. I hope you receive it. Let the word of God come in you. Let the word of God change you. Amen. To be what God called you to be. Amen.
Yes.
So praise God. Amen. Thank you, all those of you that are watching, listening.
Yes.
If you haven't made Jesus, we're about to close out the old year and open a new year. So if you haven't accepted Christ, you know, all you have to do is say, Lord, I repent.
Yeah.
I receive you as my Lord and Savior. Amen. And press on with him, you know. Say, hey, I want to be involved in the things of God. And he wants to use you. He calls you and he's equipped you. All you have to do is find your Bible-based church where they preach the word of God, teach the word of God, and start reading the word and be a mighty soldier for God. Amen. So press on with the things of God. Hallelujah. I hope that bless
praise
you.
God.
It blessed me. Amen. So praise God.